So this is the setup I will ride. I think that now I have just the necessary, and that should be pretty doable possible. So here got most of my everyday clothes.
So I had like one short, pretty cool. My tracksuit jogging, which I've been using most of the trip. I had one padded pants for when I'm riding unicycle, very useful and quite comfortable. I had like this, which is like some thermoclothes, like a pants and a top, which are very good, highly recommending one of these. Then I have this, which I've been using most of the trip when I was riding. It's quite cool that you have like this bag, which is breathing a lot, so it's very nice when you're driving, especially as I was having a backpack, then my back was not getting too sweaty. Next, I had this, which was, just a raincoat, pretty good, super light, made the job, got it for €1 in a second-hand shop. I had this top, which is quite warm, very good one actually, I like the texture, it's quite soft and very light and keep me warm. Then like some big socks, military surplus from the Swedish army, keep me warm most of the night. Socks for when I ride most of the time, and some kind of like free time socks. Underwear, I don't know, some kind of a scarf, and then my shawl for keeping me warm.
And that's pretty much all I had in terms of clothes. I had like this top, which has been very good, but it died at the end of the trip, so I already got rid of it. And then I had like this other top I use. Same good, nothing crazy about it. All these clothes, they were split between beyond me, obviously, and some were in my front bag, and the other ones were in my back bag of the unicycle. Okay, so let's get to the next things.
My helmet, which was really cool. I was super happy someone gave it to me, and I wanted to have a cool animal, and I think like an eagle was pretty nice. So thanks so much for the guy who gave me this helmet.
And my washing stuff?
As you see, quite minimalistic. A towel, a toothbrush, and some toothpaste, mini one. And I had this one, these things, which anyone who is traveling on bikepacking or unicycle know what it is. It's some cream for your butt, because...
Tu sais la vérité, frère. J'ai mal au cul, putain.
So, next things next, all my sleeping gear. I choose to go with a hammock during the trip. Personally, I sleep way better in a hammock than a tent, and it's super light. Then I had my rope, which was just here for holding my hammock together, and the good thing is like I was using the same rope as well for some trick when I was doing some show, so one stone, two bird. I had like this little silk back, sleeping bag kind of, so I was putting it inside my sleeping bag, get you some more degrees, and the good thing is like keep your sleeping bag clean, and then when you go to someone you can just wash this and it dry up super fast. I actually changed my sleeping bag when I start the trip. At the beginning I had this one, too big, not so much warmer, so I just bought like this very small one, which did the job very well. So get a good sleeping bag, it's quite important. For sleeping, that was it. My hammock was just going on the back of my unicycle, and a sleeping bag I was having it in my backpack. Now, my friend, we are getting to the serious stuff. The food necessity. I keep it quite minimalistic, but I think it was a very good choice. So what I had was this cooking pot, was very nice, did the job pretty well, and easy as, light, clean, pretty good to use. I had two boxes, empty one, so sometimes you can just cook, keep some of your pasta in a box and eat them later on. And the next things I got is some spicy mix. So basically I had three different mix, one mix of spices, which was basically some green herb de Provence, stuff like this. Another one which was like more like Napolitan style, and a third one which was more like Mexican style, like very spicy stuff. And I highly recommend doing it, because spices are like the makeup of food. If you're having a shit day, you can put some makeup and you're gonna look alright. If you're having a shit dish, can put some spices and it's gonna taste good. So yeah, get some spices. I think that was a very good idea.
Actually, during my travel, I've been creating some new recipe, which I will gather in a small video series called Backpacking Gourmet, or How to Cook Like a King Even in the Middle of the Forest. So subscribe to my channel to make sure you won't miss it.
Next things, the electronic part. All the electronic I was taking around with me was mainly here for filming video like the one you've been watching so far. What I had was like this power bank. Pretty good, I very recommend it. It's quite nice, it has like a solar panel on it. Honestly, the solar panel is not necessarily making a big deal, but the good thing is that you got a light. Yeah, pretty bright. And yeah, good power bank. I could recharge my phone like 4 or 5 times out of it, so very nice. Then I had a hard drive to store my film as long as I was writing. I have all my filming gear. The good thing is that everything was fitting in this bag. I'll make another video when I detail a bit more this. Next things, I had my juggling clubs. Juggling clubs and Diabolo, for me, that's really a little. I think I've never traveled with such few juggling props, but for me, it's not an option to go without them. And then last things, I had my backpack. It's a Northern Face backpack. I love it. It's very cool because I can put my juggling club on the side when I'm riding. I had like a nice camel bag. It's a 3-liter camel bag. It's very good. I can just drink anytime when I'm riding, and I don't need to take out a bottle and drink. But as you can imagine, being on a unicycle forces you to keep it minimalistic. I will have like kind of a mini series with another video with like the most useful things I had that I would highly recommend to take. And probably another video with the useless stuff I have because I think it's funny. And a last one with what I would take on a next trip. Thanks for watching, and see you next time for next video.